In some of these videos, you've heard me talk about Elm as a pure language, and you might have wondered what that meant. It seems like an odd term. Well, a pure language is something technically defined. A pure language is a language that's composed of functions such that for any given function, if you call the same function twice with the same arguments, you will always get the same results, and it will not affect the outside world in any way. So for example, if we have a function launchTheMissles, is sort of Simon Peyton Jones' common example, or openCDTray, if your computer still has one of those, that is an impure function. It influences the outside world in some way. Similarly, you have a function getCurrentTime. Many languages have such a function, under some name or another, that returns the current time of day. As I'm recording this, it is 10:25 in the morning, so if I were to call that function now, it would say 10:25. If I wait 60 seconds and call that function again, it'll presumably say 10:26, and so on and so forth. That is an impure function because it pulls data from the outside world. Similarly, if you had a function that manipulates the DOM in a web page, you know, adds a new element, that changes the outside world. So a pure function can neither be influenced by nor change nor create influence on the outside world. Now, Elm does allow one slight exception, in that we have a function that is impure, debug.log, which can log something to the console, and that is impure. However, we kind of squint our eyes and pretend that doesn't exist, because generally you'd only use that for debugging and take it out for production. But even if it is in something that would be landed impure production, it's not going to cause an effect that you presumably care about. I mean, the truth is any computation is going to create side effects in terms of, hey, the processor got hot. Or, you know, bits have to move around somewhere inside the computer. It may not be in a way that we care about, but it's happening, and it's using electricity and generating heat. So debug.log is an impure function and makes other functions theoretically impure. It's just that we've decided we don't care about that particular impurity. But any other impurity, we're not allowed. So for example, you cannot have a function that directly manipulates the DOM. This is why we use virtual DOM and a render function in Elm. Similarly, you cannot have a function that gets the time of day, which is why we have to use tasks and subscriptions for things like time or latitude and longitude and other things like that. So that is a basic definition of functional purity. Now, many pure languages are strongly typed, but it's not necessarily so. Clojure, for example, is a Lisp language and can be done as a pure language, and it is weakly typed. Elm happens to be strongly typed and pure, but that's not necessarily two things that have to go together. They just do in Elm's case.